Good morning, church family. Welcome. It's Worship Sunday this week, and we're going to start with just a short announcement video, so check that out.
Hey, good morning, Pleasant Valley Church. My name is Isaiah, one of the interns here at PV, and I've got a couple of announcements coming up for you as we get going with the service.
Hey everyone, my name is Kirsten, and I'm the Children's Director here at Pleasant Valley Church. One thing that has been really exciting is that over the last couple months, we have been noticing more and more new families attending our church, especially families with really young kids. It has been such a joy to be able to love and serve your families every week. Since a lot of people are new, I wanted to start by extending an invite to all parents to have your children join us for Kids Church. Every week we have a ton of fun learning about Jesus in a way that each kid can understand and apply to their life now. We would love to have your children join us to discover more about God, as well as allow you the space to fully focus on what God has in store for you while you're in big church. For parents of young children, I also want to let you know that we would love to have your child even if they are upset. That's part of our job, to help each child feel safe and comfortable in our space, and sometimes that takes a little bit of time for certain kids. Even if you know they will cry when you drop off your child, we would still love to take them and love on them while you are at church. However, I know for parents, especially of infants, sometimes it's difficult to drop your child off for many different reasons, and I want you to know that we totally understand and respect that decision. However, sometimes your child might get fussy during service. We know that that can be hard on you as well as on the others around you. We want to encourage you to use some of the great spaces that we have created for you and your family if this happens during big church, so you can continue to be a part of the service while still attending to the needs of your child. The first space is the nursing room. This room is located in the baby and toddler area and is a space where you can go to feed, change, or even just hang out in there when your baby is having a hard time during service. There's a TV in the room that you can continue watching service from, a changing table, and even some snacks for you moms out there. Another area you can use is the cafe area and the living room with the large black couches. This is a great place to go if your baby needs to move around in a stroller or even just walk around to calm them down. There's tons of TVs around this space, so you won't miss a thing. One last area you can utilize is the indoor playground. This space is more soundproof if you are concerned about the noise and has some space for you to walk around with your child as well. And surprise, surprise, it also has a TV so you can continue watching the service. We want to make sure coming to church is as easy as possible for every family and individual. So please utilize these spaces whenever needed.
Hey everybody, just wanted to let you know that we have an amazing opportunity coming up this next June to go to Israel together. And it's not only us, we're going with Austin Oaks and Brandon Ziske again. It's going to be an amazing trip. One of the coolest things about going to Israel is that all these places that you've heard about, read about, now all of a sudden you're like there and you're seeing it and it's real right in front of your face. And it just makes the Bible come alive. And so we would love to have you come along with us. If you want more information, we've got brochures from the last trip that we took. It'll give you a general idea of what that trip will look like. We're still finalizing details and costs and all of those things. But now is a great time to start planning for that because we would love to have you come with us. So go to the Next Steps area for more information. And you can also email me, daniel@pvwinona.com, if you have any questions.
You can find out more about any of today's announcements or really anything else by taking a look at the PV Winona app, the happenings, or our website. Be sure to check out details on our upcoming Rise Feed My Starving Children day trip happening Saturday, August 6th. Meet here at PV at 9 a.m. and also please register. Also check out our Thrive Kickball and Penguin Zestos night Wednesday, August 3rd, 6:30 to 8:30 p.m. at Bud King.
Probably the most well-known passage in the whole Bible is John 3:16, because it really sums up the essence of the gospel, that God so loved the world that he gave. Generosity is at the center of the gospel. And as a child of God, it's something that I can expect God wants to express through my life. And in times like this, I mean, everybody is feeling the squeeze financially. Our church budget is feeling squeezed financially. But that doesn't change our call as children of God to express the radical generosity of our Heavenly Father. And so how do we do that? We do that with our time, and we do that with our money, primarily. These are two very precious things that we hold dear, but Jesus says it shows where our heart is, the way that we share these things and express this generosity. So let's continue as a church to lean in. Jesus, how would you have me express the radical generosity you've shown to me, to the people around me, and to my church family?
If you're new here today or have any questions, stop by the Next Steps area out in the cafe. If you'd like to worship through the act of giving this morning, you can do that on the website, the app, or the black boxes in the back, or just outside the ministry center and throughout the church. Well, that's it for me. I'm so glad you decided to join us this morning. Just a reminder that Jesus loves you, and here at PV, so do we.
This morning, as we're gathered, you know, as we do these worship Sundays, really, I think the main thing that we want to do is just to bless the Lord. And I don't know about you, but often, I mean, I'm sure you do. I know I have preferences, right? There are certain songs that it's like, oh man, I love this. This one really speaks to me. This one really, you know, really touched my heart or whatever. And then there are other songs where it's like, yeah, that's true. It's kind of like, okay. I think what I would love for us to lean into this morning together is just like, man, we have been so incredibly blessed by God. Like beyond measure. The fact that he has given his son for us. And then not to even begin to mention all of the other countless blessings that we experience in life. His provision and his protection, his guidance. The relationships that he's put around us. But this morning, I would love for us just to focus on, Jesus, you don't owe me anything. I just want to love you this morning. I want to express my love and my devotion, my affection for you, and just want to open myself up and offer my heart again this morning. So let's pray, and just in a posture of worship, let's offer our hearts to the Lord again this morning. Jesus, we give you ourselves again this morning. And just say, would you be blessed, honored, glorified through our time of worship this morning? Would the words come from just a real and honest place in our hearts? And man, we just love you this morning, Jesus. Pray this in your name. Amen. All right, let's sing together.
We're all stand against the power of our God. You shine in the shadows. You win every battle. Nothing can stand against the power of our God. Almighty fortress, you go before us. Nothing can stand against the power of our God. You shine in the shadows. You win every battle. Nothing can stand against the power of our God.
My freedom, hallelujah.
when death had claimed its victory. The King of love had given up his life. The darkest day in history. There on the cross they made for sinners. For every curse is blood atoned. The final breath in it was finished. But not the end we could have known. For the earth began to shake. Sacrifice was made as the heavens roared. All hail Jesus. All hail the Lord of heaven and earth. All hail Jesus. Oh,
Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases strength. Even youths shall faint and be weary, and young men shall fall exhausted. But they who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Isaiah 40, 28 to 31.
My right defense, my My God, how great thou art.
So this next song that we're going to do is a newer song we just introduced a couple weeks ago. But yeah, I'd love to hear from maybe Mariah and Steffi, just a couple thoughts, just things that just kind of speak to you in this song.
Well, there's a reason that Satan trembles at the name of Jesus. It's because Jesus defeated him. You know, just like in sports. You might say, oh, we're playing Central next week. Oh, no, but they're so good. We're going to get creamed. But, you know, and that's how people used to feel about death. And then Jesus came and he rose from the dead and he proved that what he says is true. Jesus defeated death. And in Jesus, you know, death has been defeated.
Yeah.
And speaking the name of Jesus brings life, and it brings healing, and there's so much power in it. And when we sing that in this song, we're not just saying those words to say those words. It's because it's true.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
There's always power in the name of Jesus. So in fear, anxiety, depression, speaking his name, there's power. Even if you don't see it immediate in the moment, Satan gets scared at Jesus' name. So,
yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, Jesus reigns.
Mariah, yeah. Can I sneak in really quick?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, I just wanted to say, if you think about the songs that we've sang already, you know, we started with Battle Belongs, and we talked about how God fights our battles for us, and then the next one is Hallelujah for the Cross, and that, you know, Jesus, he already died for us. That's past tense, it's happened. Everything we need to have a life in Jesus is we already have it because he's already done it on the cross. And then we sing about all hail King Jesus. And like Steffi just said, it doesn't matter what's going on right now because at the end of the day, we know who the King of Kings is and the Savior that we serve. And so if you continue in all of these songs, I love the set this morning because it is so rich and powerful with who Jesus is, what he's done for us, what we have in him. And so when you look at I speak the name of Jesus, just something real practical in my life, it seems to me that when I feel fear, that is when everything goes south. So in the song, it talks about, you know, anxiety, depression, worrying about things, you're afraid you're going to lose your job, whatever. It starts with fear. And just a really practical thing that I've started to do is speaking the name of Jesus. So in a moment, if I feel fear or I don't know what to do, I'm just teaching myself, okay, stop. Self, who is Jesus? What do you know about him? Speak scripture out loud, stand on truth, stand on who he is. And then when I don't know what else to pray or do, I just start saying, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. And I know that Jesus knows what I mean. I know that the Holy Spirit knows what I mean by saying that. I know that God the Father loves me and knows what I mean by saying that. And there is something so powerful in just training yourself that when you don't know what else to do, just out loud, not in your mind, out loud, in your heart, say, Jesus.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I love that because it's right, you know, in our family, we just had another baby in that infant stage. All they know how to do is cry. It's the only, and I think that's the best description of prayer, because in so many ways, we don't know what to do. We don't know what to ask. If you think about our capabilities compared to God's capabilities, I think the best thing that we can understand is how we interact with an infant. They literally can do nothing for themselves. And so I love this, the idea of when we just speak the name of Jesus, it's not like a magic word. Like in the book of Acts, there's this kind of funny story where these guys are like, try to cast out a demon in Jesus' name. And they're kind of like that guy, Jesus, who Paul talks about. And because they don't have a relationship, it doesn't do anything. But just like when my little girl cries, I come to her aid because I'm there with her. I have her back and she is mine and belongs to me. It's the same when we call Jesus' name in our relationship with him. So let's sing this song and just kind of proclaim this together. And I just invite you as we're singing, I mean, just there's probably situations in your life that it's like, this is out of my depth. I don't know what to do. And and so just invite you, we will sing this song over you and you can just reflect and kind of give these things to the Lord as we sing.
I have one more thing.
Yeah.
The enemy does not stand a chance.
I just want to speak the name of Jesus. over every heart and every mind. 'Cause I know there is peace within your presence. I speak, Jesus.
Amen.
The King. Come see the scars of love upon his hands. The King is in the room. We'll watch the darkness flee at his command. Who is this King? Who is this King? His name is
been love so great. He died so we could.
I feel
Jesus, as we declared in that song, we do want you to be the one thing that we look at. It makes me think of in the middle of the Sermon on the Mount, you're talking about not being anxious and seeking first your kingdom. And kind of in the middle of all of that, you say the eye is the lamp of the body. A person whose eye is healthy, their body's full of light. And what you're talking about is the person who just has the single focus on you. So even as we sang that in this song, that you would be our vision, that you would be the one thing, you would be the lens that we look through, and our perspective would kind of fall into place underneath the fact that you are God and you have first place in our lives. And Jesus, we just ask that you would continue to help us to do that and express that in every area of our lives. I think all of us can just attest to the fact that, man, we need you every moment of every day. Not just to help us with difficult things in our life, but also just to live rightly. And I just know for myself, Jesus, it's like, you know, you think that as you get older, maybe that if things would get easier and maybe we would need your help less, but I think we just realize we need you more and more. And so, Jesus, we just submit that again and thank you for your Holy Spirit, your presence that goes with us and stays, that you live in us. And we just thank you for that in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, let's close our time by just singing a blessing over each other.
His favor be upon you in a thousand generations, in your family, in your children, and their children, and their children. May His favor be upon you in a thousand generations, in your family, in your children, and their children, and their children. May His favor be upon you in a thousand generations, in your family, in your children, and their children, and their children. May His favor be upon you in a thousand generations, in your family, in your children, and their children, and their children. May His presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He is with you, He is with you in the morning, in the evening, in your coming and your going, in your weeping and rejoicing. He is for you, He is for you, He is for you, He is for you, He is for you.
Faithfulness, even when we are faithless, we thank you that you go with us and you lead us and guide us and help us to live in a way that honors you and reflects who you've made us to be in you. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Have a great week. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you later.